In the table, I'm showing you the equity betas of different airlines: American Airlines, United Airlines, Delta, and SkyWest. I put together this information from Yahoo Finance on August of 2017. Let's think about the risk of these firms. They should be subject to very similar economic shocks. When the economy is booming, there is higher demand for travel. Sales should increase for all of these firms. Similarly, when oil prices increase, operating costs should increase for all of these firms. It seems that the ups and downs of these firms should be highly correlated. Yet, when we look at our measure of risk, beta, we see that they have very different risk. Delta has a beta of only 1.01, while SkyWest has a beta that is more than 60% higher, at 1.64. All other airlines fall in between. Why do you think then that there is so much variation in these firms' betas? One possibility relates to what we were discussing before. Shocks to demand for travel or shocks to oil prices are business risk. While it is true that these airlines probably have very similar business risks, perhaps they have different levels of financial risk. That is, they might have different levels of debt, and that might be explaining the variation in their betas. Let me add to the tables a measure of these firms' capital structures. I am showing you the value of equity of each of these firms. This is also called market capitalization. I am showing you also the net debt of each firm. Net debt is defined as the amount of total debt the firm owes minus the amount of cash that it holds. As you will see later in the formula that I will give you, what matters for the financial risk of the firm is not the total amount of debt, but rather the net debt. In the last column, I show you the ratio of net debt to net debt plus equity. This measure gives you the level of debt as a fraction of the size of the firm and will be our preferred measure of capital structure. The firm with the lowest debt to size and hence the lowest financial risk is Delta. Not surprisingly, this is the firm with the lowest beta equity. The firm with the highest debt level and consequently the highest level of financial risk is SkyWest. Again, this is the firm with the highest beta. In sum, all these firms have similar business risk, but different financial risk. These differences in financial risk explain the differences in the equity betas reported on financial websites.